good mate of ours, Aaron, he's a geologist. He's on his way up this morning, actually, and he's apparently got some really good information on our block.
This isn't working for us. So any news that Aaron can give us and point us in the right direction
is a step up from where we are now, mate.
Absolutely. Got a lot riding on it, mate.
We don't have any other income coming in, so this is it. We've got to start getting some money back, and we've got to get it back now.
Hey, mate.
G'day, g'day.
Geologist Aaron Raddick has spent over 20 years helping international mining companies locate gold deposits in remote corners of the world.
I was able to get the old drill reports that have been done in the past.
Beautiful, mate.
The great news is, about 5 kilometres to the northeast, you've got a really well-defined gold structure. This gold structure goes southwest, right through this northeast corner of this lease.
Around 2.5 billion years ago, fault lines formed across this region when layers of greenstone rock and granite collided. Then hot pressurized fluid, carrying gold and quartz from the Earth's mantle, travelled towards the surface, where it cooled and hardened, forming gold-bearing quartz veins.
Previous exploration companies had found some great results from this northeast corner.
Now that you say that, that southeast corner, I found a drill hole.
Well, we think it's a drill hole. We're not too sure. So maybe that's something you might be interested in having a look at.
That's exactly what you want to find. That was the only area I couldn't find any information for. Okay. So can you guys take me to see this? Because if this is a single drill hole down there, that's the most exciting news I've heard all week.
A second drill site on the claim's southern border would mean the gold-bearing fault line runs through their entire lease, giving them 1.5 kilometres of potentially gold-rich ground.
This is it, mate.
This is what you want to see. That's excellent.
Drill holes like this are dug to test gold levels. They're only drilled if there are significant signs of gold.
When this work was conducted, gold was at a 30-year low, which is why the mining companies weren't able to find it economically viable. We've got our known gold up here where you're digging your pit, and this is just perfectly in line.
Exactly where you said it was.
So from this point on, if you're concentrating your work just straight along this gold structure, your gold's hosted in quartz veins.
Yep.
Quartz on the surface is a great indication.
Okay. For it.
Bad news is you got 1.5 kilometres of work to get into.
Hey, no time like the present, mate. Thank you very much for the information.
Really do appreciate it, mate.
Yeah. It's like we're on the money, mate.
We know exactly where we're going now and what we've got to do.
This is pretty exciting.
The plan is
do a bit of a costing and see if we can find the contact zone between the granite and greenstone, and there should be quartz coming up in between the two.
The gold-bearing quartz vein rises and falls inside the fault line. The most effective way to hunt the gold is to dig trenches or costines at 50-metre intervals and check for the gold vein.
We need to find it and start making this operation pay a bit because it's hasn't been working so far.
I've got bills to pay back home and I've got a lot at stake riding on this. I've got a family to look after, so, you know, these little tiny bits and pieces that we're finding just start paying the bills.
The dirt from each costine will then be pushed into 15-centimetre thick pads to be detected by hand.
I'll just get some water on that.
Chuck some water on, let's have a look.
Yeah, wow.
You see that line coming up?
I didn't think it would be that clear, you know what I mean? So what I'm looking at here is you've got your greenstone here and you've got your granite here, and then you've got a contact zone here which leaves a gap. Hopefully that's where the quartz has oozed up and brought gold with it. So hopefully we've got a bit of gold up here and happy days.
Hey, Brad,
is that a target?
That's a target, I reckon.
It's exactly where it should be too, isn't it?
Exactly.
You've got the shear zone right here.
Oh, wow.
That's amazing. I don't want to take too much out.
Yeah, don't lose anything.
No, let's try that. It's probably quicker if you just tell me if I try on the ground.
This is down here now, mate.
All right.
It's in. Yay.
Woo-hoo.
That sounds awesome, mate.
Oh, this has to be gold.
It has to be gold.
That's a nugget.
That is awesome.
That's
unreal,
how
man.
Cool
that is
that?
So awesome.
Oh, mate.
To have him sort of tell us and show us exactly where we should be digging and to find a nugget is incredible. I'm going to go get an excavator, start moving. You're going to keep detecting this, see if you can find another one, eh?
I'm going to try my hardest.
Let us know how you go. Righto.
Hey-ya, hey-ya.
Yeah, she's down here. There we go.
Another little nuggy. Very happy with that. And it's only not even 3 feet from the other one. We could be onto something here. Yeah, Brad, I want you to come right up here and I want you to swing it out and dump it on the flat there for me. I'll lay it back as you go.
Yeah, copy that.
The gold retrievers are digging a second trench, or costine, to locate the richest part of a kilometre and a half long gold-bearing quartz reef.
We don't have any other source of income coming in, so this is it. This has to work. We have to start getting a return.
The 30-ounce target this season is the bare minimum we need just to pay the bills and pay the mortgages.
Yeah, I can already see a quartz coming in, mate.
Well, that's a good sign. Good start, anyway.
So this is quartz. This is what we've been looking for, and hopefully underneath there should be a lot of this stuff running in our line. Yeah, this season's make or break. Spent all last season setting up, so it's full steam ahead, and we've got to put our whole heart into it. And there's a target. That is a sound and a half. That sounds very strong. That's definitely a target. Oh, we've got something decent in here. That's amazing. That's what we're looking for. We need lots more of these. Devil's cut's starting to pay off. Probably 10, 11 grams. Brad!
How big is it?
10, 11, 12.
Yeah, boy! Well done, man, we're doing it.
The advice we've had from Aaron has been spot on. He has really put us on the gold. We should have got him up a year ago.
I'd say we're pretty much on it now. I think Aaron's been a huge help. We found exactly what he's told us that we would find, so I think we're going to be on the big money. Well, that's a good sign. So I've got it in the scoop. Hopefully it's not rubbish. Still in the scoop. Getting excited now. This is a big signal. This sounds really good.
There it is there.
All right, so this is absolutely fantastic to find. It's a great sign. Only one way to find out if there's any more. Let's get into it.
How you going there, Bradley?
Good, mate, good. Found an Aggie. Ooh, there we go.
There's a Taji.
You can dig that one out, mate. Give you something to do. Ooh. Good scoop.
I love that sound.
Good scoop. What do we got? What do we got?
Hey,
another one.
That's
nice.
Sweet little piece,
yeah,
isn't it? It's such a small little patch too.
It is. Good. It's good sign.
Right, I'll go get the loader and lay this last little bit
out,
mate.
Cool. All right, I'm gonna go get a drink.
There you go.
When are you gonna lay this out?
Now.
Hang on.
You serious? Oh, seriously.
Yes. That sounds pretty good. Right there. Hopefully it's a bit of gold. I don't know, you haven't laid this out yet, so it could be a bit of rubbish.
Nah, that came from deep, mate.
Mate, I'm hoping so. Look, I just don't want to get my hopes up, you know what I mean? That's sounding good. That's sounding really good.
You can see it already, buddy.
Is that it? that's got to be the biggest, eh? Mate, we're going to start paying some bills.
We made a few $1,000s today.
I might even crack a smile on the wife's face yet. We're actually starting to find some gold.
Hey, Brad, grab your scales and a beer, mate.
Onto it, Chief. Done well this week, eh?
I think we're taming the devil's cut, mate.
I think we are. I think you're right.
I got a good feeling about this one.
We've worked so hard for this. I think we deserve to have a win, and, you know, it couldn't come a better time. It really couldn't.
Holy dooly.
That's awesome, man. That's wicked, eh?
4.924.
Yeah, that's good, you know.
$12,240.
Yep. We're starting to get some money back, which is good for our investment, but that's a great start. Absolutely unreal.
Mate.
I'm stoked with that.
This haul pushes their total to nearly 10 ounces and confirms the findings of Aaron's geological research.
We're on track, and, you know, with the information we've got now, we know exactly where to go, so another 1.5Ks to go. We're going to slay it, man, this season. So,
well done, eh?
That's good, man. I'm happy we're getting some money back.